since we're part of the matrix of nature, since those other organisms are part of our life support systems, when we wipe them out, we're sawing off the limb that civilization is sitting on. We've lost about half the wildlife on the planet in the last 40 years, and curiously enough, the wildlife's getting its revenge. We're, at on one hand, wiping out organisms by eating them and bringing them into markets, and on the other hand, they're wiping out us by passing their viruses on to us.
We start to focus on species extinction, but we were losing focus on population extinctions. Population extinction is when you lose one or two or several population of a species, but the species is still alive. Losing populations at the regional or local level is like extinction.
Once a species gets close to extinction, it no longer carries out the functions we need as human beings. And what we did in this paper is brought home data on the species that are on the brink, the things that are getting very close to extinction already. When you wipe out one population, that may cause a cascade of extinctions in other populations.
There has to be really important conservation measures imposed at the global level, really, really soon. There are ethical, philosophical, moral, religious, many kinds of reasons to save species. But the most important reason perhaps is that unless we save plants and animals, it will be impossible to maintain the conditions that make life possible, and human life in particular.